And welcome back to SFL Nights with AJ Stryker. Thank you so much for joining me today or tonight or whenever you decided to hit that play button. I really do appreciate it, y'all. I hope that you had a fantastic week. It has been a great week for SFL. The SFLM regular season did wrap up on Wednesday, and I think that it was definitely a bittersweet moment for some teams because that was their last game.
No, God!
Yeah.
No, God,
Yeah, I
please,
know.
no! No!
I know. I
No!
know. I know.
No!
But good news is we do have a lot of great things coming down the pipeline, like for instance, some semifinals action coming up. Then the
Yes.
championship. Then the
Yes.
rookie draft.
Yes.
See? So we got a whole lot of good stuff coming up for you. So no worries. Speaking of good stuff, I do have my SFLM Week 8 review. The semifinals standings as well. And then for my fourth and goal interview, I will have Jess Otis Boudreau and Rain Rowe on the show tonight. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. All right, and welcome back to my SFLM Week 8 review. I chose Boise, Idaho, Albuquerque, and Madison to win. And in the end, I wound up guessing two right and two wrong. So about half and half all season, not bad at all. I'll take that. First up, we had our 2-5 San Jose Flight taking on the 4-3, excuse me, Boise Mud Dogs, and the Mud Dogs won 25-21. And this was a nail biter. The Flight put up three touchdowns all game long in the second, third, and fourth quarters. And they also had 371 yards passing, 38 yards rushing, 409 yards total. The total time of possession was 20 minutes and 57 seconds with one turnover. The Mud Dogs scored in every quarter with a touchdown in the first, a field goal in the second and the third, and 12 points in the fourth. They also had 267 yards passing, 53 yards rushing, 320 yards total. Their time of possession was 21 minutes and 48 seconds with no mistakes. Player of the game was quarterback Spencer Gordon. He had 21 completions out of 31 attempts, 267 yards, one touchdown, and a quarterback rating of 105.2. So, congratulations, Boys and Mud Dogs, and congratulations, Spencer. Next up, we had the 5-2 Ottawa Cavalry taking on the 2-5 Birmingham Fuel, and the Fuel won 24-10. The Cavalry scored their only 10 points in the fourth quarter, and they had 232 yards passing, 72 yards rushing, 304 yards total, 304 yards total, excuse me. Time of possession was 20 minutes even, and they had one turnover. The Fuel were busier, scoring 7 points in the first, 3 points in the second, and 12 points in the fourth. And they had 140 yards passing, 120 yards rushing, 269 yards total. They had the ball for 23 minutes and 14 seconds with zero turnovers. Player of the game was Micah Dillon with 27 attempts, 125 yards, one touchdown, and one reception yards. Congratulations, y'all. After that, we had the 3-4 Lincoln Rattlesnakes taking on the 3-4 Albuquerque Adams, and the Adams won 27-20. The Rattlesnakes scored a touchdown at the end. Unfortunately, it was not enough to win the game. They had a field goal in the second, wait, a field goal in the second, a touchdown in the third, and 10 points in the fourth. They also had 290 yards passing, 22 yards rushing, 312 yards total. The time of possession was 24 minutes and 53 seconds with one turnover. The Adams had 14 points in the second, a field goal in the third, and 10 points in the fourth. They also had 194 yards passing, 54 yards rushing, and 245 yards total. They held the ball for 18 minutes and 13 seconds with one turnover. Player of the game was quarterback P.J. Slaughter, making 12 completions out of 21 attempts, 194 yards, one touchdown, and six rushing yards. So congratulations to the Adams for winning that game, and to you, P.J. Slaughter. And last but not least, we had the 5-2 Madison Lynx taking on the 4-3 Annapolis Navigators. And the Navvies won 26-21. The Lynx put up a good fight, scoring 14 points in the first and 7 in the second, but that was all they could do. They ended up with 175 yards passing, 113 yards rushing, with 288 yards total time. The time of possession was 17 minutes and 32 seconds with two turnovers. The Navvies scored 10 points in the first, 3 points in the second, 6 points in the third, and 7 points in the fourth, and had 232 yards passing, 179 yards rushing, and 411 total yards. They held the ball for 25 minutes and 15 seconds with one turnover. And the last player of the game for the season of SFLM season was Hugo Reynosa. Now, Hugo, I remember calling your name a few times. So people going to be after you, bro. Congratulations. You had 24 attempts, 168 yards, two touchdowns, and 27 reception yards. And since Annapolis won their game, that automatically knocked Albuquerque out of the semifinals contention. No, there was a lot of hearts broken on that, but you know, I want to say specifically to all the teams that are not in there, that you guys did a great job. To the members of the Adams, the Flight, the Fuel, and the Rattlesnakes, all of you guys, do not be discouraged. You did a fantastic job, and I really am proud of all of you guys' performances, even though you're not in the big show. I mean, it doesn't matter. You got a chance to showcase your talents for longer than any of us old heads did, so that is amazing, and I wish you guys the best in the draft. And I wish you all the best in your SFL careers. And to everybody that's still in the running, I wish you guys the best of luck as well. And that would actually be the 6-2 Madison Lynx, the 5-3 Ottawa Cavalry, 5-3 Annapolis Navigators, and the 5-3 Boise Mud Dogs. So congratulations to all of you. You guys made it to the big show. Super proud of you guys as well. I want to see some great ball from all of you. You know, I'm sure that you can do it. I'm sure your coaches got some great game plans set up for this moment. So I wish all of you the best of luck. If you're going to ask who I think will win the semifinals, I think that Madison and Annapolis are going to win. But prove me wrong, guys. If you don't like what I said, please, I encourage you to do so. Some of y'all been doing it all season, so. But next up, I have my fourth and goal interview. So y'all keep it right here. All right, and welcome back to my fourth and goal interview. I have a wonderful guest here that has been actually helping me on the podcast with highlights. If you're loving them, it was from this gentleman here, Mr. Jess Otis Budo. How do you pronounce your last name, dear?
Well, the player's name is Boudreaux.
Boudreaux.
Yeah. My wife, I give her credit for that name. So, and it's kind of like I was telling you, as teachers, we have to maintain a barrier between us and our students. Mm-hmm. So anytime I'm in any kind of online community, I use a pseudonym so they can't find me. And when I saw what this was, I was like, I got to have a name to hide behind. And so I asked her, and she's the one that came up with Otis. So that's where it came from. And I like it. So it works.
Yes, it does. It fits you very well. But if you don't mind, just for the community, give us a little bit of information about yourself. Of course, you don't have to give us your name.
But like, no, my name actually is Jesse, or I go by Jess. Oh, God, we don't have enough time for me to even give you the highlights. I'm originally from Ohio. I'll be 56 in a few weeks. Everybody always seems kind of shocked with that.
What day?
June 29th.
My birthday is June 26th.
Oh, well, happy early birthday. We'll figure out some way to celebrate that together. And because it's after I hit 50, it was kind of like, yeah, okay. But my mom has the attitude you go backwards. So that's what I'm starting to do. So actually, I'm going to be 44 this year instead of 50. So, but oh gosh, I'm originally from Ohio. I spent 10 years in the Air Force as a firefighter. Got injured doing that. And I got out, moved to Nashville, Tennessee, where my parents were. And at 29, I was told I'd never be a firefighter again. And that was what I'd always wanted to do. So I had a kind of a readjustment period in my life. I went into law enforcement. I worked in law enforcement for 5 years, left that. Went into corporate America, did that for about 5 years. And then I started dating the lady that I eventually married. She was in North Carolina. So I moved here, went back to school. The VA paid for me to go back to school because of my injuries, and became a high school history teacher. And I just finished my 15th year of teaching, 14th year. Yeah, 14th year of teaching. And I love it. I mean, I really enjoy it. And my wife and I'll be celebrating our anniversary on the first day of the draft. We'll be married 17 years. So I've got 4 adult children, 3 from my first marriage that are, my ex-wife's English, so they're overseas. Okay. And then I've got a 26-year-old stepdaughter that I pretty much raised since she was 8. And you know, it's, This has been a dream come true for me because of my injuries, I've had to really change my life. Mm-hmm. And this is allowing me to experience things and meet people in a way that I never would have.
And so, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. You know, we have a lot of servicemen that are in with us. And so, you know, thank you for your service and all you've done. And
thank you.
Especially when you suffer injuries like that, it can be very trying. And even for someone, you know, like me, finding this community was awesome because, like, I love football. I would never go out there and play it in real life. I just won't do it. I'm not going to go out here and get hit, for real. But, yeah. You know, it's awesome to be able to see and live out, you know, that on screen, you know?
Right. And it allows us also to kind of dabble into things we like doing and, mm-hmm. and enjoy, but we know we'd never get a career out of, you know,
right.
Like you said with me with the videoing, I like doing that and it's something I can play around with, but as a career, no, there's no way I would ever be able to do something like that. But, and it's kind of my way to give back, you know,
I really appreciate it because you've been putting together some really, really nice clips. And
well, thank you.
Is this your first time actually doing clips like that, or have you done it before?
That kind, yeah. I mean, I've been an online gamer for 6-7 years now.
Nice.
I've got my Twitch channels, YouTube channels. I've played different video games and put them on those platforms. So I was used to editing video.
Mm-hmm.
And then when schools went to online formatting and online learning, I started doing that even more. So it just kind of fell into something that I've dabbled in off and on for years.
Well, that is awesome. Great job.
So thank you.
And I'm thinking about your history, you know, your work history and everything. Looks like the only thing you haven't been was a doctor or a lawyer.
My brother's an attorney, and I've got 2 nieces. One's that's going to be is actually at LSU right now in their doctoral program to be cancer research doctor, and my other one's at Ohio State to be a veterinarian. So I guess if we expand it out, we've got just about everything covered. So
yeah, you sure do. That's awesome. So tell me, how did you find us?
About 5 weeks ago, mm-hmm. I'd finished my online schooling. We had to be available from 8 to 12, and I'd finished school, and I was kind of in a not good place. I mean, it was, I hadn't left my house in 3-4 weeks, and, you know, and it looked like things weren't going to change. I miss sports. I love British soccer, and I watch that a lot. I've actually been to England a couple times to see a team play, and it's not one of the big teams. It's a team actually called Bath City, in the city of Bath, but it's a much lower level team. And so I couldn't watch that. I couldn't watch football. And so I was on my satellite looking through the sports channels, desperate to find something to watch. And I saw this thing said simulation football. And I thought, what the heck is this? And I opened it, you know, I turned it on, and my wife's sitting there, and I'm like, oh my God, what is this? And I quickly realized it was a video game, and it was one of the few sports games I didn't own. And so I got online, I read about it, and I've talked to different guys over the last few weeks getting to know them. They're like, well, I researched it for 2 weeks, and no, I didn't. I got on there. It's like, football and people. And so I got on Discord, and I already had a Discord account, and I went in there, and I'm like, okay, how do I get involved in this? And I realized that's pretty much the wrong approach, because everybody comes in and says that, and then half of them disappear in 15 minutes. And I said, okay, how do I start at the bottom? You know, they were talking to me about players. I said, okay, I'll figure the player. How do I get involved in this? And I was telling Coach Craven, I don't remember who the guy was. I know it was a scout at Baltimore. And he said, become a scout. And I'm like, okay, how do I do that? And he said, start messaging head coaches. So I did. I went and looked at the information channel, which teams didn't have scouts. And I started sending them DMs. Said, hey, I don't know anything about this game, but I'm willing to learn if you're willing to help me. And within 2 hours, I'd been talking to Berto, and he said, yeah, sure, I'll take you on. And then we kind of realized, after I'd been scouting for him for a week, wow, if I want a player, it has to be on Madison's team, or I'd have to quit scouting for him. And so the deputy commissioner helped me kind of get that sorted out, and Otis was created, and, you know, and here we are. So, and it's my wife, it's I heard Frank kind of talk, and I was watching his podcast with you, and my wife's the same way. It's like, oh my gosh, I'm so happy you got something that you enjoy, something that you can do. And I kind of laughed with her when the schedule came out, and I said, okay, honey, this is the opening weekend. And she's kind of realized Wednesdays are, forget it. basically from about 7 o'clock at night until I go to bed, I'm cutting game film, I'm watching, doing scouting reports every night. And so I told her opening weekend, I said, this is a schedule. And she said, oh, that isn't too bad. And I said, yeah, but it goes on for 12 weeks. And she just gave me the look, and I was like, okay, well, what do I need to do before this all starts? And ironically, our anniversary is the first day of the draft. And I mentioned that to her, and she said, okay. And I said, honey, I'm a kicker. Kickers don't go in the first round. I think I'm pretty safe. And she just kind of looked at me. She said, if you do, okay. Her support has made this even better for me. We kind of have, we're big Ohio State fans way okay. back. I've been a Buckeyes fan since I was knee high to a bullfrog, and I converted her right after we got married. And we used to have this thing where she would, on Saturdays, she'd make football food. She'd make wings and pizza, and we would kind of sit and watch football games all day and kind of culminate with the Ohio State game. Mm-hmm. And she said, if you get drafted on the weekends when the games are played, she said, I'm gonna make football food so we can watch the games.
No, see?
So, you know, she said, like this past Wednesday, she watched three of the games, and she's already said Wednesday night she's going to take her nap Wednesday afternoon, so she's going to be ready to watch the game Wednesday night, because she knows if we win that game Wednesday night, I'm not going to go sleep till 2 in the morning.
That is amazing.
So it's – that's – I've got the community, and then I've also got one heck of a wife that supports me in it 100%. So
strong foundation.
Yeah, yeah.
I like it. So how did it feel to actually see yourself out there on the field playing?
It was weird because I had I was the kid in middle school that would trip over a blade of grass. You know, so I was real short. I tried to play football, and I played 6th, 7th, and 8th grade.
Okay.
I remember my 8th grade year, I broke my tailbone. They would hide me as an outside linebacker behind the big defensive ends because I wasn't afraid of anything. I had an older sister that used to use me as a punching bag. So I had no problem at all going in there and trying to sack the quarterback. And so they'd stick me in as an outside linebacker, and I'd run around the defensive end because I was a little quick thing, and I'd get a sack or I'd pressure them or something. And they couldn't do it that much because people would figure out what was going on. Well, this one team figured out real quick, and they put a defensive lineman as a fullback, and I didn't see him, and I come around the corner, and he hit me. And so I broke my tailbone, and I was out the rest of the – that pretty much ended my football career. But to tell you how crazy I am about this, they had me keeping stats.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'd travel with the team, and I was sitting there, and we had intercepted the ball, was running it back for a touchdown to win the game, and I had the pencil in my hand, and I went, yay, and I stabbed myself in the leg with the pencil.
Oh, my God.
And I still have the pencil lead mark in my leg. So that was my luck when it came to sports. So to see Otis go out there, and the first game that I played, I was a punter, and it was the third game of the season, and I went out there and I punted it and buried it at the 1 yard line. We forced a 3-and-out. Very next series, it was like a 46 yard touchdown pass to our backup tight end, and we won the game. And it was like, wow, that was really cool. And then when I moved over to kicker, yeah, my first field goal attempt was a miss, and that was kind of disheartening. But I kind of redeemed myself last week. I went 100% last week. So it's really cool. You know, and it's kind of nice because it's something I know I can enjoy without my students finding me and ruining it. I mean, lack of a better way of putting it.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I'm glad that you're having a great time. You're enjoying the league. You're enjoying everybody, and everybody has been, you know, welcoming to you and everything.
Thank you.
Do you think your wife would want to join? Perhaps create a player too?
Yeah, I talked to her about that, and she said no. She said this is my space.
That's beautiful. She gave you what she liked to do. That's awesome.
Yeah, she said it would be kind of cool, but she said it's important that we do our own thing. I mean, we teach in the same high school. We work every day. So, I mean, she's my best friend, and we spend as much time together as we can. And so we both realize it's also important for us to have things that we enjoy that are on our own. And she said, I want to watch you. I want to celebrate it with you. And she said, but that's your space. So, and I respect her for that. So.
She sounds like a beautiful and lovely woman.
She is. I vowed after I got divorced I would never get married again until I met her.
There you go.
Yeah.
So that was fate.
Yes, absolutely.
Beautiful. So do you plan on getting involved in the league in any other capacity besides being a player? You want to be on the writing team or broadcast?
Well, I scout right now, and I've been talking to different some teams about the draft and some possibilities with that. And that's one of the things that's kind of my condition. I want to continue to scout for Madison because I think that's a good learning experience for me. And I guess it's kind of cliche. Everybody says, well, I want to own a team. And if the opportunity presents itself, I would be open to that. But I want to watch Otis, you know, become the Hall of Fame kicker, and I want to watch myself personally go from being a scout who's never seen the game to becoming the best scout, and then moving into coaching and becoming the best coach that I can be, and then general man, assistant GM, and as far as it will go. Every day is a blessing, and I enjoy it all. So I'm not going to set any expectations that I would be disappointed with. I'm just going to enjoy the ride and see where it takes me.
Exactly. And especially by being your rookie year, you want to kind of enjoy the player. You want to try and enjoy the games and without all the responsibility.
Yeah. You know? Yeah.
Ever since I've turned GM, I watch the games, but I'm also watching for other things. I'm also, my mind is going like 100 miles an hour, just thinking about other things in the league that I have to do. And sometimes I do find myself, you know, having to say, hey, Ashley, take a step back and enjoy yourself, you know?
Yeah. So, and that's the thing that I don't want it to become, to feel like work.
Right. And it does, I mean, in a sense, it feels like my dream job.
Right.
It feels like something that I would definitely want to do full time.
Right, right. And as long as, and that's kind of the way I, as long as that's the way I feel about it at the end of the day, I want to see how, but if I ever take a step and I was like, okay, this is just more than I want. I mean, I'll be honest, Ashley, right now I'm spending between, I would say 15 and 20 hours a week working on scouting. And yeah. I still don't feel like I'm doing a good job. I feel like I can get better. There's things that I need to learn how to read. I spend a lot of time on defense, and I actually talked to Eddie one time. How do you read the defensive backs? You know, you can read the initial formation, but because of camera angles and it's so reactionary, how do you determine how exactly the initial call was? You know, man is easy to pick up, zone is easy to pick up, but beyond that, it becomes real problematic because it's so reactionary. So I want to be able to do that. And that's going to take time, and that's going to take practice. And I don't mind doing the work for that to happen.
See, and you have the drive and the ambition to do that. That's how I know you're going to excel in anything that you put your mind to. I mean, Your history can say that, you know, you've done everything. But yes, it has been a wonderful experience talking to you. But it is one more question that I have for you before I let you go.
Okay.
I want to know, well, actually two.
Okay.
What type of personality will you bring to someone's locker room if, you know, when you get drafted? I'm not going to say if, because you're going to get drafted.
I'm just going to be me.
Okay.
I mean, one of the things that I learned as a young boy and was reinforced to me through my military career, my law enforcement career, is everybody has something different to bring to the table, and we have to be open to whatever that is, and we work and together, and we succeed together, and we fail together. We're there to cheer each other when things are going great. And we're there to pick each other up when things aren't. And that's who I am. You know, I'm going to do whatever I can to help whoever I can. You know, my kind of philosophy has been you pay it forward. You know, when things are going good for you and somebody needs help, you help them out. And then, somebody, if you need help, somebody's going to help you out. And that's what I bring to it. That's me. So that's what I bring to a locker room. I don't have a fake persona. I have a fake name, but not a fake persona. And so that's easy for me because that's who I am. And that's when whoever drafts me, that's what they get. A guy that's, and I don't need everybody saying just did this, just did that. No, that's not it. That's what I can bring to the table. And if it means that I'm sitting there cutting film to send to somebody so they can have their own personal highlight reel to keep forever to say, hey, this is something that I was involved in. And that helps them feel good about their experience and get the most out of it, then that's what I do. If it's helping with a podcast, then that's what I do. If it's sitting and watching 15 hours of defensive plays to try to figure out, or third down plays to figure out what's going on, why are we struggling on them, that's what I do. And that's what I bring, is me.
And, love it. I love it. just so everybody knows, I would like to have Jess on the Arizona Scorpions team. So don't draft him early, okay? You already know where we're drafting. So I figure I'll put that out there. Hopefully it works. I'm sure it won't, but you never know.
Well, thank you. That to me, that's a great compliment within itself. Yeah. So thank you for that.
Anytime. But I'm very serious. I'm very serious. But last question is, how do you handle the trash talk and adversity?
Be a police officer. I mean, I spent 3 years on the road, and then I spent, or 2 years on the road and 3 years in a jail, as the assistant jail administrator. Mm-hmm. You just kind of say, okay, whatever. You know, I'm a very, and my wife teases me about this, I'm a very factual guy. Mm-hmm. So somebody starts trash talking to me, I'm going to start throwing statistics at them. I mean, that's just the way my mind works, you know. Okay, well, you're saying this. Well, according to this data, you're wrong. And so it kind of loses its potency. I let other guys do that. You know, I just kind of sit and watch it. And I think there's a very fine line that we have to be aware of, that where it's trash talk is in the jest or in the guise of the game. And when we cross that line and it becomes personal, then it's a problem. And so my kind of thing is I just kind of stay out of it. There's people that enjoy it and are good at it. And like I said, that's what they bring to the table. They're good at talking smack. So let them do it. I've had students tell me, you know, oh, I don't like what you're doing. Well, if you want to call me names, let me know. I'll tell you the really good ones, because I've had them called to my face. And so when you're standing there with a guy that's, you know, I'm 5'10", and somebody that's 6'6", and they're telling you that they're going to have you do things that are physically impossible, and you have to take it, you know, trash talk is just that. It's talk.
Got it.
So... you know, I just kind of like, okay, whatever. I got other things. I'm going to go watch game film. You know,
I got it. Gotcha. it is definitely a pleasure having you on the show. You're invited to come back anytime that you want to.
Thank you.
Yes, especially like after you get drafted, get your reaction, you know. And
well, you will see a different man cave at that point.
Okay.
I've already told the wife that once I get drafted, it's going to be decked out in SFL and team regalia. my British football friends will not be too happy, but you know, this is where my heart is right now, and so it's. I've already got it laid out, flags, team flags, and the whole nine yards. So
awesome. Well, tell them to come join. They don't have to be mad. Just come on.
That's what I told them. I said, because there's a couple of them that love American football. I said, dude, you guys got to check this out. Mm-hmm. And I'm making some headway with some of them. I think we're going to see some of my British friends start joining. So I think that's really cool. And
tell them to say that you told them to come in, you know, so we can give you credit for that, too.
All right. I'll do that.
So this is the end of the interview. Thank you so much for coming. But I would like to give you the last word. So that can be a shout out. That can be a song. That can be a poem. Anything that you want to say at this moment, the floor is yours.
I knew this was coming because I listen to all your podcasts. And you always do this. And I was thinking, okay, this is what I want to do. And I'll be damned. It's complete blank now.
It's okay.
Yeah, I guess that my shout out is to everybody out there that is bringing who they are to this experience. because all of us together is making it what it is for all of us. And from the commissioner down to the guy who just joined today, the person at command and said, here, how do I do this? I want to be a player. Collectively, this is awesome. And I appreciate people like you who do what you do to put the voices out there. You know, Craven with Coach with his podcast, and people that are willing to come out of their comfort zone to make it a better experience for everybody. And don't be afraid if you're in it. And I know I hear people say this and they're going to look at me and say, well, who the heck are you? You've been here 5 weeks. But don't be afraid to try something new. Because the worst that can happen is you don't do good and you learn from it and you get better.
That's it.
I mean, don't be afraid to come out of your comfort zone. This is your opportunity to write your own story. Make it yours, however you want it to go. And I appreciate everybody I've met. I've made some, what I would call some good friends already. The Madison coaches, the players on Madison, the deputy commissioner, and he'll take the time to listen to someone who's been here the short amount of time that I have. All the guys in the minor leagues, I mean, the camaraderie that we have in that chat room, in the general chat room, and how accepting people are once they kind of, and there's a hesitancy, which I would expect of like, okay, here's somebody new. Are they going to flame out in 15 minutes, or are they going to be somebody that's going to actually be here? But once they realize that this is something that people are passionate about, how quickly they embrace them and how accepting the whole community is. And I've said it before, this is the best kept secret in the esport community. In a way I want it to grow, but in a way I don't, you know. The selfish side of me says, we got something good here, and I'm glad I'm a part of it. But I know it is going to grow. It's too good not to. So I want to thank everybody for being who they are and making this what it is, because I think it's going to get even better, and I can't wait.
And it will, and you're going to be a part of it, so it's going to be amazing.
Yes.
Yeah. But I do understand what you mean, you know, how definitely want the league to grow, definitely want, you know, more people involved and get, mm-hmm. you know, bigger. The more people we have, the more teams we can have and all that kind of stuff too. But I do understand what you mean too, like that small kind of close-knit group of people, you know, that you get a chance to talk to every day and converse mm-hmm. with, all of that.
Yeah.
So I get it. Yeah. But hey, when the new people come in, we just welcome them in like family too. And the people that stick around, awesome. If they find other avenues, then wish them the best, you know?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Awesome. Thank you, Jess. I appreciate it.
Well, thank you.
All right. You have a good one. I'm going to be looking for you out there. I'm
looking okay.
forward to seeing you.
All okay. Right. Thanks, Ashley.
Anytime. Bye.
Bye.
And welcome back to my Fourth and Goal interview. Tonight's guest is Ray. How you doing, Ray?
Doing just fine. How about yourself?
I'm doing fantastic. It's great to have you on the show.
Oh, it's great to be here. It's great to be here.
And so you are one of the new rookies in the league?
I am. I feel like I'm one of the hottest rookies in the league.
Yeah.
May I say?
So tell us about your experience. How are you enjoying being on your team and everything? And tell us,
well, the Birmingham,
tell us what team you, tell us what team you're on too.
I believe they put me on the right team. I feel the Birmingham Few, we really came up short this year, but I enjoy every minute, my brotherhood, the locker room, everything about this team I'm on.
Fantastic, man. So let's give us a little brief overview of yourself, like name, age, hometown, and some interesting facts about you.
I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana. I currently live in Florida. I'm 43 years of age. I am a mental health counselor. And love football.
Okay. And so you're a mental health counselor. What does that job entail, basically?
I work with clients with a mental disability. Mm-hmm. I help them get jobs, work with them, like a life coach. I take them out in the community, you know, help them shop, help them cook, you know, those little things. Love it.
Oh, man, that's admirable. Kudos to you for that. And so you say you love football.
Thank you. Love it.
Okay, so did you play? Did you ever play any sports?
I played from Little League up until college, up until semi-pro football. I spent 7 years in semi-pro.
Nice. So what was that experience like being a semi-pro player?
It was great. It was great. It was I never wanted to stop. Being with a team with that camaraderie, everything, it's just that's something that can never be taken away from me.
True. So what happened? Why did you stop?
MCL tear, and that just really ended it all for me at the age of 37.
Yeah, because it'll take you, over a year just to get back right. Then you got to go through physical therapy. Yeah. I got you. Dang.
Well, no, but I don't think my body will hold up.
No. What position did you play?
Strong safety.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Gotcha. So what position are you playing in the league right now?
I'm playing cornerback. I feel like I'm a shutdown corner over there. Call me the prime time of the league, because that's what I'm going to be.
Okay, prime time. So why didn't you choose strong safety? Was that position just not available, or you just wanted to try just to
– I did.
Oh, okay.
I did. I chose strong safety. The position wasn't available for me, so he told me to go to corner, and I can move to strong safety later on, you know, when it's available.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. So tell me, how did you find this?
Well, that it was kind of funny because a YouTube video came to my phone, mm-hmm. and I bypassed it. I just decided to say, let me see what this is that keep on telling me to look at this. I finally looked at it, and I was like, I was amazed, and I wanted to be in.
Awesome. So do you plan on participating in the league in any other capacity besides being a player? Like, do you want to write for the SFL beat team, or do you want to do stats or broadcasts?
Actually, I am on the stat team right now. I'm learning. Steve Hacker, you know, do to help better the thing for me. So I should be doing stats this week.
Okay, fantastic. Hey, I've done them too. It's a great experience, but it is very fast paced. So just be ready for that.
I'm definitely ready.
Yeah, gotcha. So what is the most important aspect of being on a team in your eyes?
Chemistry. Chemistry is the most important thing to me, because if everybody can vibe together and talk and communicate a little bit better with the team.
Okay. Gotcha. So what kind of personality will you bring to someone's locker room?
I want to be a leader. I want to be a leader. I want to be someone everybody can go and talk to and say, hey, how to make myself better. And I want to be that person to guide them to that. So if I have the inequality that I have, I am a leader. And I hope I can be a leader to my team I'm going to.
Okay. And so in return, what do you expect from the team that drafts you?
I expect for them to to treat me fairly and let me grow. I want to be able to grow with you and see how far we can take this.
Okay, gotcha. So how do you handle the trash talk and adversity, especially like you just came in and you just lost and somebody's talking smack you? How do you handle that?
I really don't even get the trash talking too much. I just want everybody to see my play on the field. You know, I think it's going to speak for itself at the end of the day.
Okay. Fantastic. All right. I have one more question for you. So what do you think about the Birmingham Fuel's basic overall performance for the season?
We had a few mishaps. Our defense is great. It's fantastic. The offense with Ben Stone, he's got it up and running, but like I say, we just come up.
You kind of blinked out right then, but I think you just said that y'all just came up short.
Okay. Came up short every single game.
Hey, no worries. Well, I'm sure all of you will definitely make a difference on the team that you guys are drafted on. And don't worry about that. This is just practice. It's just practice.
Oh, yes.
All right. Fantastic. Well, listen, I know that you are on the road right now. You're traveling. So the next time I will talk to you, hopefully you have been drafted on a team. And you'll be nice and happily placed.
Yes.
But this does end our interview. So
I'm looking forward to a next interview.
Oh, absolutely. And so what I like to do for my guests at the end of the interview is to give you the last word. So that could be a poem, that could be a song, or just a simple shout out to whomever you want to give that to. Right now, the floor is yours.
I like to give a shout out to the Havens where I work at, Noah, Jimmy, Frank, everybody out there, because they rooting for them and they watch my games every single week. So this shout out goes to y'all.
Oh man, fantastic. Well, have fun in the league. And like I said, when you do get some more time, be happy to sit down and talk to you some more. But I thank you for the time that you did give me. You have a good one.
You're so welcome. You too. Yeah. Thanks.
Bye. Well, that's it, guys. Thank y'all so much again for joining me. Special thanks goes out to Rain Rowe and to Jesse Otis Boudreaux for being on the show. And again, thank you, Jesse, for the clips as well. He has been providing all of the clips that you've been seeing thus far. So, man, you've been doing a great job. I really do appreciate that. If you are interested in being on the show, please do not hesitate to ask me. DM me. I'll definitely try to fit you into the schedule. I'm sure I will. But I'm looking forward to bringing you guys another great podcast next week. Probably more interviews than anything. So I'm looking forward to that. But y'all have a fantastic weekend. Stay safe. And treat each other well. Striker out. What we need is love, and what we need, everybody, we want vice versa love to all the hungry, vice versa love, come on and get some, vice versa love, come on and get it. Vice versa love.